The White Lotus and the Red Lotus. Two sides of the same coin, showing us the good and the bad a faction with powerful and influential members can bring. So here is our power ranking of the players in each faction. The White Lotus, number 5, Master Piandao.
And you think you deserve to learn from the Master.
As a non-bender, people might dismiss him as weak, but Master Piandao is far from it. Having spent a lifetime training in physical combat and mastering swordsmanship, Piandao was a formidable opponent. When he trained Sokka, it became clear just how much respect he had for the art.
Why would you agree to train someone from the Water Tribe?
The way of the sword doesn't belong to any one nation. Knowledge of the arts belongs to us all. Sokka, you must continue your training on your own. If you stay on this path, I know that one day you will become an even greater master than I am.
But it wasn't until he helped protect Ba Sing Se that we really saw the power a non-bender can have in a battle full of souped-up firebenders. The Red Lotus, number 5, Pili. We all remember Sparky Sparky Boom Man, the first firebender we ever saw with the ability to combustion bend. But he wasn't the only one. Enter Pili, the next generation of combustion bender.
I've waited 13 years to feel this warm.
And just as much of a thorn in the side of the new Team Avatar as Sparky over here was to the old Team Avatar. And combustion abilities aside, Pili was even skilled enough to regulate her body temperature to survive extreme cold for years at a time.
The intense cold prevents her from firebending.
There's certainly no way anyone's breaking out of here.
That's what we thought about the other three prisons.
Must be something exciting going on. No one interesting has visited me in 13 years.
Don't get used to it.
He's out, isn't he?
I'm feeling warmer already.
The White Lotus, number 4, Master Paku.
Good morning, Master Paku!
No, please, march right in. I'm not concentrating or anything.
When we first met Paku, he had some troublingly old-fashioned views.
You didn't tell me your friend was a girl.
In our tribe, it is forbidden for women to learn waterbending.
Even though he was supposed to be the teacher, it turned out to be him that learned something from Katara.
You can't knock me down! Go, Katara!
Once he saw the error in his philosophy, he proved not only what a good teacher he could be.
Katara, you've advanced more quickly than any student I've ever trained.
But also just what a waterbending master can do. And just like Piandao, he showed us his power in the Battle of Ba Sing Se. The Red Lotus, number 4, Ming Hua. We've seen characters turn disadvantages into great advantages in the past.
I see with earthbending. It's kind of like seeing with my feet.
And Ming Hua did just that. Using only her body motion to waterbend, she was able to effectively replace her missing arms with the liquid tendrils. Ming Hua honed this skill out of necessity. And it was that necessity that drove her to develop the ability to far beyond anything we had seen before.
You have no water. It's over.
Not yet.
Even inventing some entirely new and frankly terrifying techniques in the process.
Now it's over.
The White Lotus, number 3, Zhang Zhang.
To master the bending disciplines, you must first master discipline itself.
After seeing countless firebenders use their abilities for pure destruction, It was Zhang Zhang who first showed us the power that can come from self-control and restraint.
Fire is alive. It breathes. It grows. Without the bender, a rock will not throw itself. But fire will spread and destroy everything in its path if one does not have the will to control it. That is its destiny.
It's clear that Zhang Zhang was incredibly wise to understand that simple but elusive concept. But his wisdom also extended to knowing not only when to practice restraint, but also knowing when to unleash his power. The Red Lotus, number 3, Gazan. Lava bending is such a powerful ability that it was once thought that only an avatar could accomplish it. Which is why it's even more impressive that the earthbender Gazan was the one who seemed to have taken the skill further than anyone before him. Lava bending combines the fluidity and range of a waterbender, the raw energy of a firebender, and can cause any traditional earthbending attack to backfire on its user.
I can't beat this guy! It's like I'm giving him ammo!
Think about it. How do you fight someone who can turn the very ground beneath your feet to lava at any moment? Gazan is someone you don't want to mess with. Unless you're Bolin. The White Lotus, number 2, Bumi. Can you think of another 112-year-old who is in this good of shape? Okay, that doesn't count. But Bumi's advanced age often led him to be underestimated.
You thought I was a frail old man, but I'm the most powerful earthbender you'll ever see.
And time again, Bumi proved that his earthbending power was unmatched. Despite his quirky and often silly personality, those who knew him well could see that he was secretly full of wisdom and strategy that complemented his power.
Neutral Jing is the key to earthbending. It involves listening and waiting for the right moment to strike,
making him an unstoppable opponent. The Red Lotus, number 2, Zaheer. While Zaheer was a non-bender for most of his life, that didn't stop him from becoming a major threat, leading him to be locked in one of the highest security prisons in the world and guarded around the clock.
You know the drill, Zaheer.
Of course.
So when Harmonic Convergence bestowed him with the power of airbending, it only amplified his threat level.
You wouldn't want to singe your friend, would you?
How? You're not a bender!
Even though he had only just gained the ability, his extensive knowledge of airbending techniques and philosophy helped him to rapidly pick up the skill.
You seem to know a lot about airbender history for someone who just got airbending.
I've always admired the culture.
And while he wasn't quite as proficient at airbending as a true master, it was his influence, strategy, and willingness to do some horrible things that made him so dangerous. Oh yeah, and also he can fly.
Release the avatar.
Enter the void.
This is your last warning.
Empty and become wind.
No, stop!
Did he just fly?
The White Lotus, number 1. Iroh. Where to begin when talking about Uncle Iroh? While he obviously has the firebending skill to earn his place as number 1 on our list, he also had the sheer force of will and determination to drive him to overcome even the most dire of situations. But his most valuable attribute is beyond the physical. It's his immense wisdom. Iroh is a man who made mistakes in his life.
If the city is as magnificent as its wall, Ba Sing Se must be something to behold. I hope you all may see it someday. if we don't burn it to the ground first.
But he was able to use his experience combined with the wisdom he had learned to undergo incredible personal growth and take the long and difficult road to redemption. And it was that personal journey that led him to guiding his nephew, Zuko, to a similar redemption, saving him from the evil influences that surrounded him every day.
I know you must have mixed feelings about seeing me, but I want you to know I am so, so sorry, Uncle. I am so sorry and ashamed of what I did. I don't know how I can ever make it up to you, but I...
We think that's even more powerful than any firebending can be.
How can you forgive me so easily? I thought you would be furious with me.
I was never angry with you. I was sad because I was afraid you lost your way.
I did lose my way.
But you found it again. And you did it by yourself. And I'm so happy you found your way here.
It wasn't that hard, Uncle. You have a pretty strong scent.
The Red Lotus number one, Unalaq. When we first met Unalaq, we had no idea that he was a member of the Red Lotus. But we did know that he was immensely in tune with the spiritual side of waterbending, able to tackle dangerous spiritual threats with ease. While he was certainly a formidable foe just as a waterbender, his threat level skyrocketed when he used harmonic convergence to fuse with Vatu and become the Dark Avatar. This Dark Avatar had the potential to become the most powerful villain we've ever seen in the Avatar world so far. Luckily, Korra and the rest of Team Avatar were able to intervene and stop Unalaq from plunging the world into darkness. And there you have it. Do you agree with our lists? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.